Hi friends, my name is Itlali and welcome to LifeHouse Kids Church Online. It's so wonderful to see you today. We have an awesome time planned for you, so please get comfortable wherever you are and get ready. Friends, I am so excited. We are starting a new month today. We are going to be learning all about someone very important who has a plan for you. Do you think you know who it is? Yes, you are so smart. God has a plan for you. And just like an ice cream sundae, God's plan for you is super, super sweet. Are you ready to get started? Okay. First, we will sing some worship songs to God because He is so awesome and we should tell Him that we love Him. Next, we will play a fun game with colors. Then, we will listen to a true story from the Bible about God's plan for someone. Last, we will practice this month's memory verse. Friends, it's time to stand up and worship God together. Everyone, on your feet. Do you know that God has a plan for you? And God has a plan for me? It's true. When I say, who has a plan for you? You say, God has a plan for me. Who has a plan for you? God has a plan for me. That's right. God does have a plan, a really, really awesome plan. So let's sing this out together.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust Him. I know that I can trust Him,
yeah.
No matter what the season,
yeah.
His plans are for a reason,
yeah.
I know they are good, I know they are best. The reason I know is because He said He's got a plan for me, He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me, He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know, oh, that's what I know. That's what I know, oh, that's what I know.
And when I'm feeling so sad,
hey,
when I am afraid, God will never leave me. No, 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 cause love will never change. I know they are good, I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because I said He's got a plan for me, He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me, He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me, He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me, He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me.
That's what I know, oh, that's what I know. That's what I know, oh, that's what I know.
Friends, are you ready for a fun game? We need to find lots of colorful items. I'm going to say a certain color, and then I want you to go find something that is that color and bring it back. We'll count from 10 so you know how long you have to get it. Are you ready? Okay, go look for something blue. Go and find something blue and bring it right back. Ready, set, go!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Wow, you found some great blue things. Let's do this again. This time, I want you to go find something that is red. Find something red and bring it back. Ready? And go!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Can you show me what you found that is red? Wow, that's great! Let's try this one more time. This might be a hard one. Will you go find something that is the color purple? Ready and go!
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
What did you find that was purple? Great job, friends! You found lots of very colorful items. Today, in our true story from the Bible, we'll hear about a boy who had a very colorful coat. Are you ready? Here we go!
Ho! Ho! You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down to the clubhouse where wonder never ends at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Here is you
at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Here is you.
I can't wait to see what's inside.
Oh, hello there, friends. Welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Kai. I'm so glad you're all here today. I was just about to do something really fun and exciting. Do you want to help me? Great! I was hoping you'd say that. My mom gave me this big bin of stuff to look through. She said it will help me with my plan for a very special party. An ice cream sundae party. I am so excited. Let's look inside. Whoa! Check out these colorful ice cream bowls. These definitely need to be part of my party plan. Oh yes! Spoons! You can't eat an ice cream sundae without spoons. Spoons definitely have to be part of this party plan. And so are these decorations! These streamers are perfect!
Who? Who?
It's Ollie!
Hello, Kai. Who? Who? Planning a party, are you?
Hi, Ollie. I sure am. I'm putting together my plan for the very best ice cream sundae party the clubhouse has ever seen. I'm so excited.
Party planning is fun. It's true. I have a story about a different plan to tell you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through hell. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hello friends. I'm Casey, and I'm helping out at the cupcake food truck. Happy Ice Cream Sunday Month! And what better thing to go with ice cream than cupcakes! See the little ice cream cones on top? I made them for my friend's ice cream sundae party. He has big plans for his party. That reminds me of today's story. If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, "Tell me a story." 1, 2, 3. Tell me a story. Okay. So today's true story from the Bible is all about a plan. Did you know that God has a plan for you? It's true! God has a plan for us. And he had a plan for Joseph too, like we see in this true story from the Bible. This is Joseph. Hi, Joseph. Joseph had 11 brothers. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Whoa! That's a lot of brothers. One day, Joseph's father gave him a special gift. It was a coat! An absolutely beautiful coat. When the brothers saw Joseph had a special coat and they didn't, how do you think they felt? Do you think they felt happy? Show me your happy face. Or do you think they felt mad? Show me your mad face. Which do you think they were? Yes! They were mad that Joseph had a special coat and they didn't. So they took Joseph's coat away and threw him in the ground. That's not good. That would make me sad or mad or even scared. But do you know what? Joseph knew that God loved him. And he knew that God was always with him, so he could trust God's plan. Just then, his brother showed up and pulled Joseph out of the hole. Uh-oh. What are they doing? The brother sent Joseph with some people going to Egypt, and they took him really, really, really far away. Things were not going well for Joseph. But he knew that God loved him, and he knew that God was always with him, so he could trust God's plan. God loved Joseph and had a plan for him. In fact, there is a lot more of Joseph's story to tell. And God loves us, and he has a plan for us too. Did you like the story? If you did, give it 2 thumbs up. 2 thumbs up. Hey, Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. God had a plan for Joseph, and he has a plan for you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you.
Wow, what a story. Joseph must have been really scared, but he knew God loved him and was always with him, so he could trust in God's plan. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. Well, speaking of plans, I need to get some help planning for this ice cream sundae party. I think I'm gonna get my friends to help me. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.
Our Bible story today was about a man named Joseph. It didn't matter if he was getting a special coat, being thrown into a big hole, or being sent far, far away by his brothers. Joseph kept trusting that God had a plan for him. The new Bible verse we're going to learn will help us remember that God has a plan for us too. God has a plan for you, and God has a plan for me. The verse says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord." Jeremiah 29:11. Let's stand up and say that together with the motions. Are you ready? For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. Great job, boys and girls. God loves you, and he has a plan for you. Who has a plan for you? God has a plan for me. He sure does. And that means that no matter what happens, we can trust that God loves us and has a plan for us. Will you talk to God with me now? Dear God, thank you for all our friends watching and praying right now. Thank you for the way you made them with special thoughts and abilities. I pray as they grow up, they will dream big, work hard, and always trust that you love them and have a plan for them, no matter what happens. We love you, God. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for praying with me. I am so glad we spent this time together learning about how God loves you and that He has a plan for you. Make sure to come back next week when we'll learn so many more amazing things about God. See you next time. Bye.